This is my lovely keto mango cake topped with cream cheese icing and it's absolutely fluffy, light and moist.
Hi guys, I'm Sonal and welcome to my channel. Today I'm sharing the recipe of a keto mango cake with you. And in this one, I'm using one mango, so about 100 grams, which is 12 grams of carbs. If you don't like using fruits, you can always leave it out. I'm using this because I enjoy the flavor of that and it doesn't really come from mango essence. And mangoes are in season. Alfonso mangoes are our favorite. I decided to use a little bit. This cake can be completely made without it. And I'm also putting the macros along with mango for this cake. So check those out and then you can go ahead and watch the recipe. The base of the cake itself is great. So you could use this for any kind of flavors. You can add blueberries to this and make muffins or anything that you like. So let's go ahead and watch how I make this recipe.
Hey there, have you subscribed us yet? If not, click the subscribe button and the notification bell immediately. So in case you decide to use the mango, I want to show you how to clean it. So you take the top off and then I hold the peels and keep rotating the mango while you're peeling it. Okay, so this is very easy to do with the Alfonso mango. It has a very thin peel. There is a flat elongated seed in the center which needs to be taken off. So you make cuts on top and then you run your knife along the seed. Now I have taken a little less than 1 cup, which is about 96 grams of mango, and I have cut about 1 tablespoon into tinier cubes, which I'm going to store for using later. So let's set this aside for now. Here I have 3 eggs. I'm not making a tall cake because I'm trying to cut down on the carbs in the cake so that I can use those with the mango puree. And here I have powdered sweetener, so I'm using erythritol, about 1/4 cup and 2 tablespoons, which is 1.5 times of 1/4 cup. Then 1/3 cup of white vinegar. This is 1/3 cup of butter, and I have used salted butter. If you're using unsalted, you might want to add a pinch of salt. 1 cup of almond flour, 2.5 tablespoons of coconut flour, and 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder and 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. And I'm going to strain this so that you don't have any lumps, and you'll see that we'll have a few lumps which I've taken out. And now I'm mixing all of this together so I don't do the wet and the dry separate mixing and stuff like that, but you could. Now here is about 1/2 teaspoon of mango essence that I've added, and you will see that my batter looks a little curdled. Frankly, that's how my batter looks, and it rises really well. So here I have a baking pan in which I have put a parchment paper at the bottom. Put it in the oven, 180 degrees centigrade or 350 degrees Fahrenheit, for about 35 minutes until a toothpick that you put in the center comes out clean. We have 1/2 teaspoon of gelatin, 2 teaspoons of water, and we've mixed it and set it aside. It is optional, you don't have to use gelatin. And I have made a puree of the mangoes. I've heated the gelatin for 30 seconds in the microwave and then added that to the puree. And we're gonna put it in the refrigerator while our cake cools down. My cake is out. We are going to let it cool down a little bit. Now let me get it out of the mold. I'm using a springform pan, which is about 8 inches.
So let's make the frosting.
3/4 cup of softened cream cheese, 1/4 cup of butter. You can use less butter if you want. And this is again salted butter. So if you're using unsalted, add a little bit of salt. And 1 tablespoon of powdered erythritol. I'm also going to add some stevia, but before that I'm going to taste it. And 1 more tablespoon of erythritol. So as I adjust it, I am tasting it. And then I'm adding 5 drops of stevia. So I am going to keep some of it aside. I've used a piping bag and I've put it in that. I'm just going to put this in the fridge and get it out of the fridge 20 minutes or so before you want to frost it.
Once it is cooled down, we are going to use the mango puree that we made and we're going to top the cake with it.
So I'm spreading the puree in the center, and if you can do a better job, kudos to you.
Let me tell you, my daughter, who doesn't eat as much keto, liked the cake. So I'm sure you guys are going to like the cake too. So try it out.
Now we have the cream cheese, which was also in the refrigerator if your cake is taking time to cool down, and I am putting it on the sides of the cake. You have seen that I've inverted a plate so that it becomes easier to kind of turn it around. If you have a lazy Susan, you can use that. I have one, but I just wanted to show you this trick. So I do this a lot. So once you've covered the sides with the cream cheese, you can even clean it a little bit on the bottom. And I'm going to show you how to transfer this cake onto another platter. So take 2 flat knives or spatulas and put them under the cake in opposite directions and then just carefully lift it up. Here I have my toasted coconut flakes. that I toasted some time ago. So I am just taking them in my hand and sort of like pressing them on the side till I cover all the way around, and they're delicious and crunchy, and you want to make sure you've toasted them. And when you have the privacy that I have right now, you can also drop them on the counter and then pick them up and put them back on the cake.
All right, so we have our piping bag ready. I have the frosting on the sides and some lovely toasted coconut flakes, and they absolutely add a great crunch to the cake. I'm gonna pipe the florets on the sides and then top the small pieces of mangoes that I had on each of those florets.
So I'm using these tweezers, which are cooking tweezers, to put those tiny mango bites that we had saved and to decorate it. But you don't need those, you can actually use your hands. And then some more of the coconut, and look at that beautiful cake and that slice, and look at how nice and fluffy it is. It's a delicious cake with or without the puree. I hope you guys try it out.
If you try the recipe out, let me know in the comments section. I have all my social media handles in the description section, so you can send me pictures of all of your recipes. I love to watch them. I read your comments. I even reply to all of them. So I have started updating my Marathi channel too. So if you're a Maharashtrian, you understand Marathi, watch that channel. I have some extra tips on that channel. And thanks for watching. Bye.